Welcome back, everybody, to Insomnia True Silver Championship. I'm your host, Nimsh. I'm here with Volthar and Noxious. And we have some weird topics offstage, but welcome to the desk, Volthar. How was your break?
Like, it was like 20 minutes.
Right?
I got a hot chocolate. I was sipping it, just, you know, casually talking with my friend. And I was like, oh, the match is over. Well, I guess I will be back here.
So. I guess JJ is too good.
Apparently, yeah. Oh, wait. He is from the same team as Noxious. What?
Yeah, but I mean, it doesn't translate over. I didn't infect him with my skill or lack thereof, and he didn't infect me with his actual skills.
Well, he has the player skills. He has the casting skills. So it's all good, man. Like, complexity for the win.
We can marry and be an actual complete couple.
We will not go there. All right, guys. The next pair of the players that we have is Legendaren.
Legendaren
versus our great player from UK, who actually qualified from the UK qualifier, winning versus Solo, and right now is 2-0 in his group. So I think he's already through. But if he wins this one, he's for sure through, and he's still in a good shape. It's Visual.
Yeah, and for him, it's like there's a point to just prove that he is a good player, right? So he wants to go 3-0.
Yeah, and he seemed pretty confident. I saw him walk around earlier, and he was talking to a friend, and they were like, yeah, I think all you have to do is this and this and this, and you're going to get through, like, no problem. He's like, yeah, sure. Sounds like he's at least...
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah, I mean, he seems like, you know when you have that adrenaline rush when you're competing, and you're just riding the wave of the momentum?
Yeah.
That's exactly what he's feeling right now.
Yeah, so he's dropping his opponents like hot potatoes.
Exactly, yeah. Dropping the potatoes. dropping them like... Hot potatoes.
Well, hopefully he will not drop the ball with the last match.
Right.
And yeah, he's facing Legendaren. This is the first match for him on stage, so he will be stressed for sure. But because he is already through, I think he should be less stressed. He can just enjoy the match and play for the public.
I mean, at this point, like, is he guaranteed to be through? Because I feel like when you're two wins.
So Tice, I think Tice is 1-2.
Right.
And
I know that much.
The other person in his group was, I think, 1-2 as well.
Oh, that would then put...
I mean, Tice is in the same situation as RDU, when three players have to be 1-2.
The same one? So yeah. if he wins, let's say...
If Visual wins 3-0 versus Legendaren...
It could be a three-way tie.
It's possible.
With Tice.
Tice's
exactly.
Group.
So, I kind of hope that Visual will win here.
Well, I can certainly hope that. He's the Hunter player of the day. I haven't seen pretty much...
No Hunters.
Any Hunter today.
Yeah,
that's true.
He has a Mage as well, so it's pretty interesting lineup. Hunter, Mage, and...
He's playing for London Conspiracy.
That's Legendaren.
Oh, what I'm talking about. Yeah, sorry.
Well, he is playing for London Conspiracy.
But he is playing for LC, yeah.
I was just surprised, you know, it's an Englishman. You know?
Oh, okay.
London Conspiracy, my first thought will be like two dots connecting, you know, and it's like, okay, he plays for London Conspiracy.
So Legendaren plays for London Conspiracy, and we did cast Legendaren before. He won Chifinity. So, Lothar, what do you think about him?
Well, I know him from the first stages of Better Game. Like, I still remember the open tournaments we played, like the mana grinds, the Swiss tournaments we had on Fridays. Yeah, I know. there was like a lot of tournaments going back then, and Legendaren was one of my most common enemies that I remember from that time. And he was a pretty decent player, but like during that time,
I guess.
Yeah, I just didn't want to use
the era,
word.
The era.
Yeah.
That was
era,
Stone Age of Hearthstone.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm really happy to see him still playing and doing well.
Right. Yep. And he did qualify for European Championships for BlizzCon the first year. He didn't make it to BlizzCon, he got eliminated, but he went really far. So it was great to see him come back this year at Gfinity, which he actually won. So Legendaren, a really good player, but then Visual, he's proving himself. He's on a roll, as you guys said, and it will be an interesting matchup. Yeah,
there was an interview, right, in the entrance, the intro videos of the entire day, where we saw him talk about how he kind of came in with no expectations.
Yeah.
You know, he knew the field was going to be stacked, and he didn't expect necessarily to beat Sotl in the first place. But then as soon as he did, he realized, hey, I'm actually in this top 16. I can maybe do this. And at 2-0, the fact that he's already through means he's already top 8, which means he's already further than he even thought he could. So at this point, I think he's got everything to win.
But he would like to advance from the first place, right? Because then you're being paired against a player from other group that has second place. and that in theory gives you the weaker opponent.
The seeding is a bit better.
Yeah, yeah, the seeding is kind of should be probably better, right? Oh wow, this opening for Legendary.
Yeah,
this like opening is legendary, and this is an aggressive. This is an aggressive druid. Noxious, please stay with us.
I said nothing. You did.
I know, right?
So, I mean, this is the first aggro druid we've seen today. All the ones we've seen, I say aggro because I see druid as saber.
Yeah.
It's an assumption that I make.
It's a very correct assumption. If we see Fel Reaver as the next draw, I would not be surprised.
Yeah. That sounds like a good prophecy.
But then Visual will get a Hunter's Mark, and this will all go to hell.
Let's see if he gets it. It looks like it's an aggro hunter as well. Which of these two out? It feels like to me like the hunter gets out aggroed by druids.
Especially with the Fel Reaver.
Exactly, just because they have no good answer to the Fel Reaver.
Yeah, the problem is that. The problem is that there's like a good opening hand for Visu, I think. Both players have good openings, actually.
This matchup is actually pretty good for Druid, I feel, and especially because of that Darnassus Aspirant. When there was no Darnassus Aspirant, you couldn't stop the early aggression. You really had to do something with the Shapeshift, Wrath. And if you go with Wiregrowth, you gain the Mana Crystal, but you can't really respond to what Hunter is doing. And right now with the minion, you not only get the Mana Crystal, you kind of force Hunter to kill it. Because you do ramp the same way, and you have a minion that's good for trading.
Yeah, it's trading like 2-for-1 maybe with their minions, so they don't want to leave it up. At the same time, the fact that he had to use the coin to get it out means that he's not really going to put out anything super threatening, right?
Unless he plays Mounted Raptors.
Right, which is, well, it's pretty common nowadays in the aggro druid, but very often, and I don't know what Visol knows about Legendarin's deck. Maybe he thinks it's a typical mid-range. And so on 3, he expects at most a shade, and he's not too worried about it.
Mm-hmm. By the way, the double owl opening hand is really unfortunate for him, especially in this kind of situation when you can't really silence the Darnassus Aspirant, right? Even if you would like to have to play it, you would have to silence your own minion.
Yeah, just to get a 2-1 on the board.
Yeah.
So usually I think this is a case of hero power and maximize your damage output, and I hope that you can raise him somehow. Yeah. Although this is a decent card.
Is it?
For Vissel to pick
because
up.
You have no way of killing both at the same time.
Keeper of the Grove could punish you.
So this looks kind of awkward.
Yeah, I mean, maybe just maximizing your damage output and getting the best explosive trap you can. Is going to be good enough. Like, let's assume the aspirant number 2, the one that's a 2-3 right now, is used to pop the spider. Then suddenly, you have 2 kills with explosive trap. So that's maybe good enough.
It's a really tough turn. Well, really tough turn.
You do have to kill one for sure.
I don't know. I don't know about that. I feel like maximizing damage output and setting up for explosive is good enough.
He's bluffing here also on the snake trap, right? Snake trap, bear trap, because if Legendary doesn't have like full information on the deck, he might be wondering why would he play the trap on turn 3, right? In this kind of situation.
Oh man, that's a really risky play. Is that what it takes to win though? Because I feel like
with double
charge,
owl, he's still super.
Charge minion to the face.
Yeah, that's right.
He's still super behind with double owls. Like that double owl is not doing anything.
It's useful when you're about to use, stuff like Arcane Golems, he even runs those, or Horse Riders, just to get, you know, some of the taunts out of the way, but in a position like this, the owls are just useless.
I think, like, as a druid, you can safely just attack with 2-1 to face, because...
It's not freezing in the first place.
If that's freezing, 2-1 goes back to hand and you're fine. If that's a bird trap, you're still more or less fine because you can play... You can just charge with 4-4 or whatever, just play it as a taunt. And if it's explosive shop, you do lose that 1 mana crystal, but you can still play something like Shredder, so you're in a good spot. Savage Combatant is nice as well. It's not even contested here.
But with the owl, I think it will be, right?
Now he has a decent owl target.
Yeah, now he does pick up, finally, an owl target that he's happy to use it on.
He might actually go for Juggler attack with the 1-2 into the 5-4.
Yeah, the Juggler and attack is
with a
like
quick shot, possibly, is even better.
It depends on the jugglers, right? If you nail a juggle on the Savage Combatant, then you use the quick shot. If you don't do it, then you'll just play Owl and silence the combatant.
What about going with the quickshot first anyway? Because then you're sure that you kill the combatant.
The exactly. That's what I'm thinking. Like leaving him with a 2-1, is that really that big of a deal? It is because you want to protect that juggler, so...
You probably quickshot first, then attack, and then you have really good chance to kill the 2-1.
No, but... Yeah, I mean, it's the same chances in the end. The only thing is, what do I leave up if it messes up?
Well, you can...
The only difference is, what do I leave alive if it doesn't hit?
Oh, well, that's unfortunate.
Well, I can see the silence.
Now you have to silence.
You have no choice, because otherwise the hero power alone kills your juggler, and that is game.
So wasn't it better to actually attack into combatants? Hmm.
That's really interesting that he doesn't want to silence this, because as you said, hero power has really high value now.
It is damage though, so if you attack with the hero power into juggler...
That's three you're dealing.
And you're using the hero power instead of playing Shredder or whatever.
Yeah, playing stuff.
Yeah.
But you have a Druid of the Saber and Knife Juggler to curve it out. So I definitely see that happening.
Yeah, I think at this point Vissoul is basically saying, I'm going all in no matter what happens here. And he's not wrong. Yeah, see, this is definitely a card he's happy to see here. You silence off that juggler, then you Argent Horse Rider. Do you just keep pushing, FaZe?
No, then you use hero power. No, you just use hero power here. You just Argent Horse Rider, kill the Knife Juggler, deal 2 damage to the FaZe, hero power. Your opponent is at 15.
Yeah.
You have 3 minions on board. If he uses the hero power, you don't care if it's 3 damage or one because it will be used to clear the minions. And that was an important lesson to silence the Savage Combatant just to
protect
have
the juggler.
The protect the juggler, but that's not the case anymore. You want to just maximize the damage each turn with the hero power.
You might actually kill the juggler with the 1-1s.
With the 1-1s instead, yeah. I'm thinking about whether or not you want to use the...
I don't think so, because there was an option to play a swipe during the game.
He didn't.
So having more targets is actually more beneficial for Vissoul, because he is always having the bigger damage output, and even if there will be a swipe, then having 1 minion doesn't necessarily help you here, because you lose losing damage anyway.
Yeah, well, speaking of that, now he finds some way to curve out, but he's still taking damage where he doesn't want to.
Well, the Druid of the Saber wasn't that bad either.
The 3-2 so stealth, yeah.
It wasn't that important. He would have been much more happy with Living Roots, an example. Than Mounted
Living Raptor. Roots would have been a lot more useful.
I would say that he might go just for the Druid of the Clone.
Right, in taunt mode right here. Because you can usually protect it unless something goes awfully wrong. And in this case, this is probably the only case where the Owls are actually doing more job than any other card that Vissoul could have.
Because they will push for a lot of damage.
Yeah.
6 damage from board and hero power. You have access to 3 more on your hand, but you'll wait for that.
So
I wouldn't be surprised if you'll just play double Owls.
To get the minions on the board.
To get the minions on the board, there was no swipe. You'll see that right now.
Okay, is he just pushing for FaZe?
Yeah, it makes sense. It's this kind of Druid. Like, there's so much damage. I was thinking if you can just hero power and play
Vissoul
maybe...
Stop hitting FaZe.
You gotta keep pushing in a position like this, because you've already committed. You can draw even with your quick shot starting next turn.
So
you play an Owl to silence off that combatant, and now you push with hero power.
Exactly. So now you silence Savage Combatant, because you need minions on board. You saw there's no swipe, because the swipe would have been played that turn.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So you push as many minions on board as possible, you deal the damage that you can, and hope there's no Savage Roar.
Well, you probably keep the second Owl, right? Like, if there's Druid of the Claw, so you want to have the second silence, but you absolutely silence the third. It makes sense, yeah. If you start trading, you will be behind because you have to spend resources.
Oh, he's trading.
Is he?
He might push.
He might still go for FaZe.
Oh, I don't like that.
Da-na-na-na-na.
I really don't like that.
Lothar dislikes trades.
Never trade.
I just like the trades. Just in this situation, you don't have enough damage output to kill him next turn, most likely. You have 4, 6, 8. Well, 11 if every single minion on board survives, right?
Well, you survive a race. Right.
I think it's not terrible that he.
Because Savage Roar killed you just alone.
And this board is super super weak to swipe still.
Yeah, Savage Roar alone was lethal. So I think just because of that Savage Roar,
I don't like it anyway.
But I mean, he could have silenced the 5-4, and then suddenly Savage Roar only adds 6 damage, and the Druid is 1 off lethal.
Yeah, exactly. That's buy you time.
So if he silenced the 5-4, he would have been like 1 damage off dying.
It's so amazing that there is still no swipe, and those small minions are doing so much work.
And the only option to have lethal that turn was Living Roots, which you know that he doesn't have.
Yeah.
Because there were so many situations when Living Roots would have been perfect. Like the an example, turn 5, right?
Yeah, when he could have just played that and differently instead.
Well, Savage Roar and Druid of the Saber was lethal, right?
You know what? When you see Legendary Trading here, you have to be thinking, well, I think I've got the edge as far as damage output
and that's,
goes.
And that's 4, 7, 9, that's exactly 11.
That's
pretty
is
cool.
Insane.
Arcane Golem for the win.
Well, this is the face hunter after all, right?
It does go face.
And you do go face.
So even though he lost the damage,
he still had what he took.
But that was the exactly 4 that he needed by losing the abusive certain attack.
Right.
So he got it back, and that was the only card that actually gave him that. Because kill command.
Huffer, possibly.
Kill command.
What?
Huffer is 4 damage as well.
But that's 33% from a animal companion when you don't necessarily might even play like 2 animal companions in that deck.
Kill command was too expensive to get immediately.
Yeah.
Because unless you went owl, quick shot, you cycle into kill command, but you couldn't play the card you just got. So
it was actually really impressive because his hand was really bad from the start. He explodes the trap into double owl.
Yeah.
It seemed hopeless.
Well, we'll see whether or not he's able to take it against a rogue. It feels like the aggression he can put together should be good.
It is an amazing
especially
matchup
the
for a hunter.
Especially the weapons.
Right.
The Eaglehorn Bow is an MVP against rogue in general because it deals so much damage. And if it doesn't deal damage to the face, then it deals with forces and agents, which are the minions that will probably be played as soon as possible, especially if the rogue is on a coin, which is not the case here. But in general, what you want to have in your opening hand is the Eaglehorn Bow.
Yeah. One of the things to keep in mind as well is that the teacher is weak to that Eaglehorn Bow plus an explosive trap, which happens. It's a scenario that comes up quite often.
Yeah. On the other hand, we also don't exactly know what rogue version is Legendary playing. So we've seen JJ was playing Farseer and Nurture, which is really good. Sometimes people play Healbutt as well. We don't know how much heal Legendary is actually backing here. And overall, this matchup is great for Face Hunter.
It should be, because there's too little healing. Normally,
no,
but
almost no taunts as well.
Right, exactly. Unless they're playing a weird version of it.
This is a tricky situation. You can play with 2 options. One is, of course, Vogan Infiltrator into Snake Trap, but that's very risky because you know that the opponent is playing double Fan of Knives on his deck and will allow for a easy clear after taking 3 damage from the Snake Trap, which is kind of okay because you dealt 3 damage from it.
Yeah.
The other option is to fake Bear Trap.
And then
turn 1,
yeah.
And then play Juggler, which will of course mean that he has a Snake Trap there. And that is very weak to backsteps. So I favor the Vogan Infiltrator into Snake Trap, even though there might be a fan of Knives.
I really don't like I don't mind that bluffing the trap or trying to get him to trigger Snake, but Rogue has to be the worst class to do that against.
Yeah, as I said, his backsteps and stuff, like he will not have to attack. So yeah, good decisions with the Infiltrator there. Double Unleash the Hounds. It's not great now, but as you mentioned, Violet Teacher, it might be good later.
Yeah, there's a few spots with, like as a hunter, where you can abuse the Violet Teacher. Like when the rogue overextends with it, and sometimes they don't have the choice. But you can punish them for that.
So do you just go with the Juggler? Or do you go with the Snake Trap first?
Hero Power be when you go Juggler, Coin, Snake. Not very good. If you play Snake now, you're usually safe.
Yeah. He's going for the Juggler, apparently.
Oh, man. Gotta dodge that SI with the backstab.
Well, sometimes you take those risks.
Yeah, you have to take them sometimes.
That's an SI. Hello?
Well, that's pretty much exactly what Legendary wanted. There's no better card in his deck for this exact situation.
Well, you can backstab and Farseer as well, but it doesn't. Like, weapon attack and Farseer, but it's probably better anyway.
Yeah, you keep the weapon charges. I think that the only question is, do you think that overkill will matter? Mad Scientist with Snake Trap looks pretty
good. I was really surprised, but enough Juggler, to be honest.
Yeah, I thought it was the middle-of-the-road play that didn't commit to like,
that was the scenario that
anyway, yeah.
Yeah, that was the scenario when you lose board control to an easy combination of cards. Even a single backstep was a problem because you don't gain anything.
By attacking to the warg and you give him the board no matter what.
Yes, exactly.
It was mostly backstab because with SA7 you have to have an activator. You have to have.
Matter,
I mean,
yeah,
even Eviscerate, it wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
Eviscerate, Knife Juggler, attack into the Vulcan Infiltrator.
Any answer was a problem.
But the thing is, it was still a problem if you play it next turn, like on turn 3. Because it still dies to the same cards.
Yeah, but if Snake Track triggers instead of the Juggler dying, then you're forcing Phantom Knife.
But it might never trigger because of the backstabs, let's say 7s, and...
Yeah, well, but with a dagger up, the Rogue would have attacked into Worgen, right?
Oh, yeah.
So that was the only line of play that we thought...
wasn't really damage efficient.
Right, exactly.
And that's what you have to be when you're playing against Rogue. You want to play as many hero powers as possible in general. And yeah, that's it.
And he didn't coin that snake trap again.
Honestly, this is pretty good though. This position here for Visul doesn't look like much, but that explosive trap weakens the minions down to 1 health, and that's
just enough.
And then
you have unleashed enough. And imagine if you would have still the Knife Juggler in hand.
Yeah, that would be a nasty turn.
So now you just have to hero power and snake trap this
turn. I like that a lot.
Otherwise, you're getting just wrecked by those two minions.
Yeah.
You can't play anything else. Arcane Golem is a great finisher, but you can't play it mid-game.
It's
just to get the all rogue what he needs to get the early combo, right?
It's much too early for that, yeah.
Yeah, but still, Lichtern is not in a bad position. Just dealing 6 damage right
double
now.
Double Unleash this turn is actually pretty sick.
How do you deal with Azrael, though?
Doctor, boom. Knife Juggler from the top? That's not bad either.
I'll take that. I mean, Animal Companion plus the Hounds.
So you double Unleash. Oh, if you get the Leok, well, it's interesting.
That's...
But you have to clear Azure Drake.
Yeah, you have to clear Azure Drake.
Oh, no, absolutely.
But then the Snake Trap would be so much better.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that would be clear. I mean, Fan of Knives, 2 Blade Flurries. There are 4 cards that are clearing the board. So that's not a problem for Legendary to take the game for itself here.
Yeah.
Like take the tempo back to switch the positioning on the board.
Yeah, he has to hope that his stuff lives, but he's not expecting it to do so. You have to kill the Drake no matter what though. You can't let that be. This is
spell damage is too much.
Just a single flurry takes the whole board away, and you can't risk that. Even though you're playing Face Hunter, you can't risk that, but you know that you have more consistent damage, but less explosive than Rogue. So if you can just kind of curve out here, that allows you to just dish out more damage in general.
Yeah, just pace your damage a little bit more. Because the thing is, you're not going to win a race if you're not killing the Drake.
What secret are you expecting? You're expecting Snake Chop, because you did attack Face. There was Explosive Chop, no freezing, so it has to be Snake Chop.
Oh, the Belcher.
Oh, wow. The Belcher will be a huge pain.
Unless he gets an owl.
For Vistula to go through.
He is playing double Iron Beak.
The Flurry will do quite a bit of work, but that's kind of what Vistula expected anyway. But that means he's got something of an open field to play with.
This is why I like
He has an open board. He can play any minion.
Yeah, play anything he wants, right? That's the dream. Until it's not.
Hero power turn. Yeah,
he got that Iron Beak for the Belcher.
Yeah, and when you're able to put the Rogue in a position where they have to, well, there could be, if Legendary had the proper cards, the lethal is not that far off. And I would turn on the aggressive gears, but not with a hand like this.
Well, I think this is Dr. Boom, actually. Because Hunter will not take you down from...
Yeah, I mean, you have to.
Well, you're happy to do it, actually.
Yeah, you have to. I mean, it's too good to pass.
And you put Hunter at 12, and you still have Eviscerate in your hand?
Mm-hmm, yep. It's only bad against what? Is there even a thing it's bad against? So Unleash Arcane Golem, how much damage is that?
You've seen one Unleash already.
Yeah, no, there's no way that's going to be enough.
Yeah, there's just not enough mana. Unleash Q Command Hero Power, like Unleash Q Command Quick Shot, it's still not enough.
Yeah, not even with the mana you have, so...
Good choice by a Legendary to play Dr. Boom. That's definitely true.
There's really no alternative, unfortunately.
Well, that was the best card, but you kind of got super defensive and go Belcher, whatever.
I guess he could have gone for something very slow, like Belcher.
Yeah. Would have been a worse play. And now Visual is in a really bad position. He just needs to protect himself somehow, but he can't kill Dr. Boom.
And that alone, the fact that Dr. Boom doesn't die, that's enough to be a problem.
Well, that's it, because you can always sub something, then eviscerate for 4, and then deal the 5th damage with the weapon.
Yeah, lethal's pretty much guaranteed.
Still have one Boombot that can hit face.
And that prep sprint last turn.
Yeah, that was a huge.
That prep sprint was huge.
Imagine Hunter's Mark.
Oh, this would be so insane.
That's it. It's a 1-1 tie for Legendary versus Visol.
Face Hunter got killed. Again, Rogue is doing good work. And we'll see if Rogue is actually sweeping the series.
Rogue is doing God's work.
Yeah, kind of.
Killing a Hunter.
And I think that was the worst matchup for the Rogue. There's Mage and Rogue. And Warlock from Visol.
It will depend on what Visol is playing. Then again, we saw the Face Hunter, so maybe he's playing a very aggressive lineup. And a lot of players that maybe don't have the exposure yet often tend to play aggressive decks. We were talking about that earlier, right?
Yeah, we mentioned that.
So
especially if he's not playing that much Hearthstone. And he's here for fun. Like he didn't have that many expectations, but he is playing those decks correctly. And I haven't seen any mistakes from him so far. So we had some different lines of play. Like Lothar was disagreeing at some point, but
yeah, with the last game, I think it was like a matter of 2 damage on one turn instead of the other.
Yeah.
But I mean,
you mean not against the Druid?
Yeah, it was another.
But
game,
I would have played the game against Rogue way different too. Well, that knife
the juggler opener, agreed.
That was I think that's something that's really risky. Might pay off. But in general, from my experience against Rogue, you can't really.
I mean, you might as well have coined the juggler on turn one.
Yeah, exactly.
If you're going to go for that play, for sure.
Exactly, that's for sure.
So, Legendary with the backstab and the SI on the coin with with the curve. Against Handlock, that's pretty good.
I know, what do we have? What is this Warlock? Is this Maligus?
We saw Molten Giant, so it could be Reno, it could be Hand.
Might be Standard Handlock, right?
Oh.
Looks like standard,
old-fashioned.
Well, could it be Reno Lock with mountains?
I think so.
No, I'm asking. I'm not.
I don't think so.
I saw some people playing that.
Yeah, I have. I have too, but
I don't believe that's possible.
Well,
okay, maybe it is.
All of a sudden, he is getting a giant on curve.
Well, Demon Wrath tells us this might be Reno.
I mean, I want to say it's Reno because of Demon Wrath, but I guess there might be an argument to be made for including it somewhere else.
And the Demon Hand.
Yeah.
Maybe he combined all the decks together. This is an ultimate combination.
Maybe he has 60 cards in his deck.
It's the Dragon Ball Z. Handlock. Everybody just plays Fusion.
It's like, what should I play? He basically asks people, should I play Handlock? Even Lock.
They have so many archetypes, dude. Play everything.
Yeah.
And Zoo all together.
Yeah, where's my Voidwalker?
There will be some eggs in there, too. NPOs.
Next turn, he's just going, just draw Arcane Golem next turn.
Like playing the combo, and all of nowhere comes Faceless.
So there's a question of a Legendary. Do I kill the Mountain Giant, or do I just sap him? The problem with the saps is that you want to keep that for the taunted minions up.
Yeah.
But if you lose Eviscerate at the stage of the game, it kind of makes it more difficult to finish up after Molten Giants.
I mean, if you sap now, you do get a decent follow-up on 5 to kill the mountain.
But
it's going to be easier to kill it, but the thing is you are wasting a sap, which is very precious.
Usually you want
and
to
he
kill
still
the
doesn't
person.
Know what type of deck he's facing.
Yeah, no idea. Well, he's assuming Handlock right now, like we kind of did when we started.
I like the kill, because you normally want to kill the first giant, and he has those subs, so he is getting a really good board. I'm using that Violet T-shirt here. Even though he's taking 8 damage, it doesn't matter. It's fine because
it's too early to matter that much,
Yeah, and he built up kind of quite a board.
Yeah.
Right?
Aha!
Implosion?
They said I could be anything, so I became anything. I mean, Implosion with Demon Wrath follow-up is pretty sweet if you hit for three. I kind of like that, but it's like Phantom Knives. Because you're baiting out the Phantom Knives immediately.
Well, he might be baited by low tap, but the low tap dies to two minions.
The two minions, right, exactly.
And the attack from the hero, and that's something you don't want to do at all. So it seems like Implosion is the best bet. But if you hit for two, that's not going to work well.
Tap Farseer, but that seems awkward with the weapon.
Oh, he goes with the low tap. I don't like that at all. It pushes for more minions when you don't have a way of clearing those minions.
What are you talking about? He has it. It's Demon Wrath.
Damn, son.
You don't believe in the Dark Bomb top deck? You don't believe in much, Lothar.
Second Eviscerate. That's actually a huge deal.
Yeah, this is an amazing situation, especially because the Azurshake will be on board for the time being.
So, of course, Legendary plays around Shadowflame.
Well, that was the best clear possible. And you're really not afraid of taking damage.
I mean, honestly, with the Farseer, the heal bot, the Demon Wrath, I think he's able to at least stall until he's able to go turn 7 with the Implosion Demon Wrath.
But,
like, what if you Farseer here, right? Like, you Farseer, and then you, I don't know, you tap. I don't really mind. But what this does is you're able to guarantee that one of the minions will attack into it, hopefully. And based on that alone, you're weakening them enough that Implosion and Demon Wrath should take care of them.
Well, the problem is there are two saps waiting. So whatever you play on board, if it's not Implosion, it gets sapped.
Healbot! Well, he doesn't know there are two saps, right?
I mean, yeah, Fan of Knives is a problem.
If you play Healbot, then you tell to your opponents, I don't have Molten Giants.
Yeah.
Well, why do you say I expect to take 25 next turn?
Well, the biggest minion is Twilight Drake.
And yeah, that's weak to sap a lot more than everything else. I'd play Farseer before I play Twilight.
So Farseer and what?
Farseer and even BGH, just because.
It's not bad, actually.
Ooh, he goes for the greedy play and he will be punished.
Yes,
he hopes
severely.
There's no Sylvanas. I mean, no sap, but there is.
Oh my god.
Goodness, this keeps getting worse and worse for Visul.
Unless the Unvin Van Cleef will be played first.
Oh no.
Just, oh, Edwin, yeah.
Yeah.
That's not going to work.
It says win in the name.
And then he goes like with into SI7 because he just activated damages Sylvanas. Oh, like, oh no, what did I do? All right, sap into Edwin is pretty good.
It does shine yellow.
Guys, we just need a very good AoE here. We need a second Demon Wrath.
We need Hellfire.
He goes for it.
Hellfire into Demon Wrath.
Or we need Healbot to stall Owl down that Edwin.
So if he goes,
but that's
Implosion, Demon
11
Wrath.
Damage on board.
Yeah, and then there is Eviscerate for 5.
That's kind of too much.
So you Demon Wrath and Implosion, one of them?
You could play both, honestly. I mean, you can kill the Drake for sure. You can go like Implosion on the Drake, Demon Wrath, you'll kill the Drake. There's going to be 7 on board, you're on 11.
Well, instead of being if you kill the Azure Drake with the Implosion, then you just play Farseer.
If you hit properly, but you're, no, I mean, you're still leaving two more damage on board. Yeah, I guess that might be what he wants to do. I just feel like...
You can also silence Edwin.
Well, that, yeah, I mean, to me, the play was Owl and Healbot. But...
Owl Healbot is 11.
Because, I mean, the thing is you want to get as far away from the death as possible and maybe set up some kind of taunt with Defender or get a Demon Wrath turn. And now is not quite when you're going to be able to do it.
Yeah, is he dead though? There is 5, 7, 8, 11, plus 5, 16.
Plus 2. He is dead. Yeah, Sap, Eviscerate, SI is lethal, I think.
Is it 18? I think he's 1 off, actually. No, he can attack.
You Sap, SI, everything goes face, you Eviscerate, I think you win. So 6, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, he's got... Oh yeah, you're right, he's 1 off.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
And he doesn't have, he's 1 mana off as well, right?
Yeah.
To kill it.
The dagger.
5-7. No, no, no. So he will not be able to dagger anyway.
Would have to be next turn.
Well, still great shape. You've just seen a Healbot, no Molten Giants. You can still do whatever you want.
But now is he afraid of committing damage?
Why would he?
Because of the Molten.
But he was not playing against around Molten's
I am telling
before.
Right. I'm just telling you what I see. I'm not saying I agree with what I'm seeing, Lothar.
Okay.
I'm asking the question.
That was a good question. It's the answer is no.
What color should I pick for my jeans? Yes.
So, based on what we have seen before, I assume that this will be the turn with Sylvanas and Sunkeeper. Sunkeeper Protector.
I absolutely hope not. But to be consistent with his previous plays, yes.
Yeah, and he's so one sap.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you go for Sylvanas because there is no way there is a second sap, but wait, there is one.
Of course there's one.
There always is, right?
This is a really bad spot.
It's tough. Like, what?
I feel like he didn't really have much of a choice, though, to navigate this game. Everything's kind of lining up against
Glanky,
him.
Yeah.
All game long.
Well, and Legendary played really well as well, just killing the first giant, having a board that just kept pushing and sapping those big minions.
Yeah, and this sap right here is the sap that he didn't expend on the giant.
Yeah.
I don't even think he needed it in this case, just based on the hand that he had. But it really gives him a lot more leeway.
So another class bites the dust, and Rogue has two wins.
Looks like Rogue is absolutely demolishing everybody here.
And Vissoy is left with his Tempo Mage.
Are you sure it's Tempo Mage?
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right.
I'm sure because he won against Tice, game two and game three, with double mana firms on turn one.
He told me he died by turn five twice.
Yes, exactly. to the same scenario, double mana firms on turn one into, you know, the usual.
Yeah, the usual.
Flame cannon, frostbolts, that kind of stuff.
Such a good mage player.
Oh, look at that. There's a mana firm.
Well, it's just the beginning, Lothar.
But Legendar has a backstep and agent.
And a coin again, what?
Yep.
All right.
Looks like a good start.
So you mulligan, you probably just throw away Azure Dragon, Dr. Boom, just keep backstab SI. And here you throw out a counter spell for sure, you might actually keep Frostbolt.
It depends what Legendary knows about the deck, right? Like, I don't know, I assume he asked around what his opponent was playing.
Scouting is actually a really important part of tournaments for card
games.
You want to have that information.
Because the mulligan is almost one of the most important parts of your game.
There is Flame Waker as well for visual, which is not bad. But for Frostbolt, there might be no targets.
To be honest, I think like Legendary already has the answers in his hand.
Oh.
Deadly Poison, Blade Flurry.
Yeah, that's already enough to wipe the board. Double Mana Worm opener for Visul. Maybe not on the coin, but still the double Mana Worm. I think he's cheating.
Somehow, he found a way to always have two Mana Worms in his opening hand.
Yeah.
Well, it happens.
They're
not even.
That's a good one.
All right. So, what do you do here? You can just backstab and kill one.
I might just wait next turn.
Do you? I was actually thinking about just coining out the deadly poison just to kill one as soon as
possible. Look at that Frostbolt, man.
Do you just Frostbolt and Arcane Missiles and just go face?
No, I don't go Arcane Missiles, but
just Frostbolt. Just Frostbolt because turn three looks amazing with the. With the Flame Waker.
This is like 5 damage. Right here. Because you buff Worms.
But you will have the same outcome with the Flame Waker.
Yeah, you will have more with Flame Waker next turn as well.
Oh my god.
Rest in peace.
Well, it's not that bad.
No, it's
I don't like that at all, to be honest.
It's pretty awful. You saw Rogue dagger up and not attack. Do you think there's no Flurry in your future?
What do you think? Like, this is a really terrible hand.
This is over for the mage. Unless Water Elemental is top decked and sticks 17 times, like after being sapped and sapped and sapped.
You're right. Well, yeah, this is the best Deadly Poison Flurry possible.
This is...
I thought that Legendarian sent him a fax saying, I'm keeping my dagger because I have a Flurry, now you remove.
Yeah.
And Vissel didn't receive the fax because the technology is outdated and it's not there yet. But I thought it was pretty clear.
I like that Frostbolt, that's for sure.
That's not usually how we cast, but I like it.
I don't know. I was,
I mean, usually you just go for the value when it comes to tempo, right?
Yeah.
And the value, I mean, by the value, I mean the fact that you use your Flame Waker in conjunction with spells to dish out the natural spell damage potential from it, right? And it seems pretty awesome to play Flame Waker with Arcane Missiles on 24 when you And when you guarantee yourself that your both mana worms will live for turn three with additional spell, because the only option to clear those mana worms is a Blade Flurry when your opponent is frozen.
So
right?
It's a coin. It's literally deadly poison, flurry, pass.
Pass, yeah. And you killed two mana worms, but you were dealt a lot of damage, and you lost the potential to wipe out the board later on. And then you just play the Flamewaker, and you don't even have the Alchemists at that point. You just can just play it and replay whatever.
Well, maybe the Unstable Portal will find the Black Knight.
Oh my god.
That would be pretty awesome, a green on a Black Knight.
That's not quite it.
But it fits the playstyle.
It does, most definitely.
It's still an awkward spot, though, after losing those minions.
Oh, let's not kid ourselves. This is awful.
you do have Dr. Boom for 7, so on 6, technically, there could be a decent play. I mean, at this point, what he has to do is basically Frostbolt to trade, see what he finds. If he picks up the Time Rewinder with Arcane Golem, that's 8 damage.
Oh, that's a good point. So, I actually didn't think about it.
Yeah, like, there's a few spare parts that can really improve his spot, but it's going to be a long ways away.
The problem is, he wasn't aggressive. That's the problem.
I guess.
Imagine if the Frostbolt would actually deal damage to the face. That was 5 damage for 2 mana.
Yeah. Instead of playing Flamewaker. Like, he really hoped there is no Flurry. He hoped there is no way to deal with the board.
If the Rogue, as Noxious said, didn't attack, that means he has to get at least a Deadly Poison. And he's just leaving it for turn 3 so it can coin out Deadly Poison alongside Agent.
Yeah, yeah.
Or the other option is Blade Flurry. Otherwise, you would always attack into one attack mana for him just to set up a good Agent for the future.
This goes to show that, in like, sometimes it's about reading into what your opponent's telling you. It's not necessarily about playing your cards. It's about, you know, why did he do what he did? It's kind of like the second degree.
Absolutely.
And, you know, a lot of pros have this habit already. It's kind of ingrained in them. And just, what is this play indicating? As opposed to maybe just playing your cards.
Well, this shows that Visual is, it's his first big tournament, right?
It is.
And also, he is probably already through. So he didn't see that one. If he's doing his best at the moment, we'll see. He got a stat swap.
Yeah, the stat swap is not the most impactful one. But it can do some work in very fringe cases.
This guy's toast.
So the Dr. Boom is usable next.
It will be a really one-sided game after that play.
Flame Strike top deck.
There is a fireball, so he can deal with Edwin.
He can fireball Arcane Golem, kill the Drake, ping the slime. He can all these things in one turn.
Can he still, like, just play Boom and hope there is not enough damage to kill him?
No, not on this board. Well, I mean, maybe he can. That's very optimistic.
He's
right?
So far behind that if he starts, like, fighting back instead of just trying to push, he might just lose anyway. And if you play Dr. Boom, if you're not dead, something has to be done about it.
I guess you're right, because when you have the Arcane Golem with a fireball, it is, well, there we go. So he does play. We're talking, like, 10 damage directly. And if you pick up, say, another fireball, then that might be the win.
Yeah, but there is a lot of them. So.
And the sap, just in case.
Yep, that's it. I'm just like
watching
this. Does he
have lethal straight up with Flurry and Eviscerate?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, he does. The spell damage will steal this.
All right, so that's basically it. 3-0 with the Rogue. It's 3-1 overall, but Rogue is great.
It looks like Rogue, every single player that we've seen play today, Freaky, ended up going with the Rogue and going with an opener that was 2-0 and then started losing. But the opener was 2-0. We saw JJ 3-0. Legendarian with a 3-0 on Rogue after getting, you know, losing one match, one game. So I feel like the Rogue was definitely the class to bring.
Yeah, it is the MVP class for the tournament, it seems. So I wonder, we probably see tomorrow some Rogue versus Rogue matches. Those will be intense.
Yeah.
I guess we haven't seen any Rogue on Rogue yet.
No, not quite.
I still remember the times when Rogue vs. Rogue was my 3-4th of the ladder time, so. Yeah.
Greetings, I will be your death.
Now, do
I
attack with the dagger in turn 2?
Right, is that. And
that's
what
the
about my
question.
Shiv? What do I do with Shiv? Like, when do I play Shiv? Do I Shiv phase? Do I Fan of Knives nothing? Like, all these decisions to make.
It can still happen with Paladin being super popular, but then on ladder you have a lot of Hunters, and you don't want to face Hunters that much as well. Even though Legendarian was actually able to win versus Hunter.
It is the...
I mean, the Hunter was... the Rogue was doing great, but at the same time, I felt like Vissoul didn't use his potential. And the Mage, I thought, had a decent chance of beating the Rogue. Like, there's not enough heal to sustain the damage. And if 2 mana, 5 damage from Frostbolt, 1 mana Arcane Missiles, 5 damage, that's already
on
10.
On turn 4. And then, right? Like, if you can top deck your way to this, like, afterwards,
yeah,
just getting that extra bit of damage initially gives you a good reason to start pushing everything. And then it's just a matter of...
And it also made Legend Darren be defensive.
All
instead of
long.
Taking advantage of having minions on board. Because if... Let's just rewind to the situation, turn 2, when the Frozen wasn't played, right? And if there will be a Frostbolt, Legendary was pushed to do the same turn, deadly poison into Blade Flurry, but then you have the defense, the initiative to play Flame Waker. You can play the Arcane Missiles, you don't have to, but you have still the minion on board. Then Legendary would have to answer with the backstep agent, but if you have the Arcane Missiles, then you have a way of making combat.
You kept it, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Right?
And you actually probably win with that fireball draw in the very
at
end.
At the end, exactly.
It's
that
possible.
Last,
I mean,
last fireball was a lot of damage, and if you already played Dr. Boom without being too threatened, because the Rogue was playing defensively, then that's possible that, you know, that might have
absolutely
been
leading
to the
Rogue. Closer, but I'm sure that Visual will just watch the games right now and see what he did wrong.
He will,
and
sure.
He will grow for tomorrow. Like, tomorrow he might be even better than today.
Super Visual.
Super, yeah. The new form. Yeah.
Like, ah, he screams all night, and then in the morning he just has yellow hair.
But possibly.
Sounds good.
All right, guys. So that was an interesting matchup. Legendarin proving that he is still really good at this game and advancing to tomorrow. I think we have one more match for you guys today. Let's see. So the last match for today will be Trump versus Freaky. Whoops. All right. Got it. I got it good this time. All right. So Trump versus
Freaky red, like
coming
this
up next. And I think Freaky is in a dire position because he lost 2 games in a row. So he needs to win. And then again, as many players, hope for the three-way tie. And that will be his chance to advance tomorrow.
Yeah. Let's hope it doesn't come to that. But
all right. So guys, stay with us. Trump versus Freaky coming up next. But now we're going into a short break. See you next.